TGC Requiem here. We are back with some modern action tonight. We're going to play something a little different tonight. Something I've been wanting to try for a few weeks and just hadn't really gotten around to and felt the urge. We're going to be playing some Abzan Traverse. This is a deck that Willie Adel started playing a while back. Started using this or playing this when the Death Shadow decks became popular, but he didn't really love Death Shadow. Jund, just not his style as much, and so he built this kind of toolboxy deck. And so that's what we're looking to play tonight. I actually kind of like this okay. We are on the play. We don't have to turn one anything, so we could bauble ourselves, see if we have a land. If we don't, we could fetch it away and Inquisition our opponent. One land's not the greatest, but we do get two draws to hit our next land. And otherwise, it's a really powerful hand. I think we're just going to keep here. Twitter handle's in the bottom right-hand corner if that is something you're interested in. Sometimes I'll do polls to see what I play each week, so you can have some say in what I play, rather, and what I end up posting to my channel. Alright, so we're going to lead with Bauble. Check ourselves out, see what we have. Scavenging Ooze, we definitely don't want Scavenging Ooze. We're looking for a land. And opponent's Mulligan to 5, so I feel pretty safe. Even if there's something super aggressive, they're probably not going to get there right away. Death Shadow. So he is, or our opponent, whoever they may be, he, she, they, are going to definitely Inquisition or Thought Sees Us, probably going after the Tarmogoy. If we don't want them to get two, I'm less worried about the Shadow. I think we take the Thought Sees, reduce their ability to get their life low. We'll deal with the Shadow later. Here's the first of our two draws. Second fatal push, so that actually works out well, since if they go for Inquisition, they're... Ooh. Definitely feeling glad we took that Thought Seize, I think. So not sure if our opponent will go after the Tarmogoy for one of our fatal pushes. Probably the Tarmogoy, if I would expect. And we got there. And just kind of wait to see what our opponent does. Not a whole lot for us to do. We would have been going into a Tarmogoyf had we got there. So it seems like we're fighting Jund Shadow here. So it took the Liliana, definitely. Looks like their opponent got stuck on one land. I'll go ahead and thin this down. I think we definitely want access to black-white here. Five card types, so we can actually traverse into a land or a creature. So this is the fun part about the tool deck. If we traverse or a creature right now, though, we could just end up getting it stripped out of our hand. I think we probably just want to go after a land, and I almost wonder if it's worth getting the Bajuka Bog and just... Our opponent playing to traverse has three of the four types already. I think that's what we're going to do here. We're actually just going to go ahead and try and put him off traverse. And then that puts us on the mana we need to cast Lingering Souls next turn. We still have Fatal Push Up. So really hoping our opponent goes for a creature so we can kill it with push and then run out of Lingering Souls on our turn. This is fine. We're just not gonna kill the shadow until that resolves. So Tarmogoyf's very good here, but Lingering Souls is more problematic for our opponent. And so I think that's what we want to go with. And this potentially allows us to cast Lingering Souls plus push or Tarmogoyf next turn, depending on our draw. We don't know any of the cards in our opponent's hand at this point. And from what our opponent has seen, it's possible they even think that we are on the Shadow Abzan. Sometimes the Lingering Souls can give it away a little bit, but not a definitive. So returning the Death Shadow, killing one of our tokens, not something I'm worried about. Opponent can't recast the creature. So here's the thing. Liliana just basically ends this game. There's almost nothing the opponent can do. These builds are typically, the shadow builds are pretty much, the Jund versions rather, are only running like one Abrupt Decay. The odds of the opponent having that Abrupt Decay are pretty slim, although they definitely have to jam. Thing is if we just jam it an uptick, even if the opponent, say, has Hand Disruption to strip our Fatal Push, we have Liliana to protect against it. So I think we're just going to do that. And we're actually just going to pitch the Tarmogoyf here. There's almost no way our opponent can get through both Liliana and a Fatal Push. And with the opponent at zero cards in hand, I mean, essentially the only thing they could do is if they hit another creature, they could jam two creatures, and even then we have them kind of covered. Liliana is actually just a complete bomb in this matchup. The uptick mixed with the ability to destroy the creature, that, you know, there's not enough creatures in the shadow deck for them to throw enough creatures out turn after turn to really play through a Liliana. Just a real, I know this isn't the mirror, but with the shadow versions I was playing with Abzan, Shadow, and even Jund Shadow most recently, it's just a mirror breaker. Granted, the deck has dropped in the meta a little bit, which is probably warrants fewer Lilianas in the main than I was playing in my most recent league. So match status, we won the first game here 1-0. So going into the sideboard, surgical extractions are a consideration. I don't know that it's necessary. None of these cards seem great. Eidolon, Ling. Lingering Souls can be all right. Fulminator Mage can be okay, but I don't know that you really have to necessarily fight that battle. Maelstrom Pulse is good. Damnation. Shriek Maw enters battlefield, destroy target and artifact, non-black creature. So it is still a removal spell for Tarmogoyf. I definitely think if we look at what we have in the deck, we're probably willing to take out some of our hand disruption against the shadow decks. We're definitely going to take out the hand disruption that hurts. We don't need the collective brutalities. I like all of these cards. I like all of these cards and these cards. So I think we may actually end up just bringing in one surgical extraction. And we could also bring in a Fulminator Mage and put them off color. That's potentially something that works. Let's see what our curve looks like. We don't want too many threes. Lingering Souls just gives us blockers for days. I think we could just bring in one surgical extraction. It's going to disrupt the opponent's ability to. Yeah, I like that. That can disrupt the opponent's ability to, go for a traverse spell. We could eat something out of the graveyard to turn off their delirium. Sometimes you get lucky and you strip all their Tarmogoyfs or Death Shadows. As the opponent, though, the opposite side of the coin, they may not be as apt to. It's not exactly the best hand. We do have two lands, Flayer. Question is whether or not the opponent would have ripped their hand disruption out. I think this is good enough to keep. I don't think we'd want to mulligan here. Opponent has mulliganed down a little bit already. Remember, we took out most of our hand disruption, so the surgical extraction is going to be more functional after a removal spell. Quite possible they're going to go after the Grim Flayer or the surgical extraction here. I feel like unless they have, if they don't, if they took a lot of hand disruption out, they may go after the Liliana, as that is such a mirror breaker. And that's fine. That was like the last card we had in anyway. Oh, they're gonna have Traverse online right away. Tarmogoyf. So we want the Tarmogoyf. I think we're just going to play the Temple Garden. And we are going to play it up right here. Hold up that path. So a little bit of a mistake there. I actually could have played the Verdant Catacombs and had the ability to go get a Marsh Flats. So we do get a little bit of insulation there. Really looking to draw another land. Tarmogoyf definitely the biggest threat. So at this point, I'm just not going to play out my Grim Flayer. There's no point in rushing it out. I have removal. The opponent's clearly representing they have a removal spell. They were willing to bypass casting a Death Death Shadow most likely on their turn. Just no reason to play into it. Put the pressure on them to make the first move. We have more grindy cards than they do. So the opponent has to choose here, probably going after the Liana, to be honest. Which makes the Grim Flayer play look pretty likely next turn. I'm gonna take the Grim Flayer, that's fine. So we're just not gonna crack our fetch here, we're just gonna hope to draw into another land. It's a minor thing, but bingo, bango, bongo. So, definitely have to go with the Overgrown Tomb. Can't cast Liliana, unfortunately, but we can start to get those souls out there. Allow us to apply pressure on our opponent. If they try and go too low with their shadow, we still have access to several pieces of removal. Be surprised if the opponent went for. Well, I guess it probably is unlikely to go for a land, knowing that they have to. Well, they did, okay. I was gonna say, knowing that they probably need to expect some removal, but maybe they already have a second shadow in hand. Definitely going after Liliana if I'm in their shoes. Pass. So maybe a grindy element like Liliana the Last Hope. They're not too worried about the fatal push. Then there's just no reason here to Inquisition. If we Inquisition and they top, well, let's think about this. If we Inquisition and they top, yeah, no, we don't want to do that. I was gonna say if we Inquisition and they top deck a Temur Battle Rage, they could get us down to one. I suppose a Street Wraith into Battle Rage could kill us. Just wait for their turn. Fatal Push in response to pretty much whatever they do. Yep, Liliana's not surprising. Nor is the uptick. So we're just gonna attack the Liliana here. We're gonna overload. With souls, Liliana's not going to be able to keep upticking and get to a point where they can downtick to get the shadow. If they want to keep going after the souls, they're going to lose their equity towards that. Alright, so now we do want to draw a black land. Black land would be really strong right now. Well, I have the choice of continuing to attack Liliana. What happens if we attack our opponent? I suppose if they have a Temur Battle Rage, we're in trouble. But if they don't, we're actually okay. I think we actually are just gonna maybe. I think with two, if we attack with two, and we play two more, the opponent kills one, attacks into one, kills one. They're at four, however. We attack for two more. The problem is this Liliana could be problematic in a gra the longer the game goes. If we attack Liliana down to two, up ticks to three, we have three left. With the chump blocking that's necessary for Death Shadow, it's almost like we can't quite race the Liliana. Think we're just gonna start to pressure the opponent's life total here. May have been the better move last turn as well. Tar Fire. So that Tar Fire changes things a little bit. The clock is going to be a little bit tougher getting at the opponent. But what we do hope to do is put the opponent in a pinch where they cannot actually crack a fetch. And I think we're just going to take this first Death Shadow. The odds are the lowest they have a Team or Battle Rage right now. So we could actually traverse for a black mana source and make the opponent sack the Death Shadow with the Liliana, and then I think we attack this Liliana using our Liliana to put pressure on our opponent the next turn. And which land do we want? Do we want to fetch? I think we may want to fetch just a thin, so maybe like a Marsh Flats into a basic swamp. And so now what we can do is next turn we can actually Inquisition and play out a Lingering Souls. Oh man, that's just straight money right there. So actually at this case we're just gonna go we're gonna Inquisition, go at our opponent and Lingering Souls, right? Yeah, because we can just race Liliana at this point. Can't imagine our opponent's gonna, yeah. And again, we don't really care about Liliana at this point because we're going to be able to throw so many souls out there that our opponent just can't deal with them. So I have to fatal push one of these, this is fine. And that should be game almost no matter what they draw. Excellent. So we got there. Abzan has, whether you're playing the shadow version or something else, Abzan has the best, I guess, mirror match against this. And we got to see in this match, even just in the two games, some power in Traverse, even just getting lands to be able to cast your Liliana, getting the Bajuka Bog to keep the opponent off Traverse in the first game. So we'll be back with the second match soon.